One fine day in summer paradise, I wandered alone, not thinking twice. Under the ultraviolet golden sun, wafer-like butterflies on the run. I think of a lens-free way to trap this glorious creature in a snap. I frame the butterfly in my head and nail it to my mind instead. So no matter where I choose to unwind, butterflies are floating inside my mind. An idle mind is the devil's workshop. The moment we get idle, the devil in our mind starts gossiping, ridiculing people, backbiting, becomes a shopaholic, or sometimes sleeps lazily. There are lots of internal and external factors that can activate the devil in our mind, like nature, environment, the behavior of people towards you, as well as politics or religion. The internal factors would include our grief, our sorrow, our happiness, joy, pride, laughter. The devil in my mind is fond of poetry. It wants to explore poetry structures in depth and give wings to my creativity. I shan't advise you not to weep, for not all your tears are evil. Let pass all the stages of grief. Take time to forgive the devil. Grief comes in 5 stages. I'm talking to the readers and asking them to cry out through all these 5 stages of grief so that we can forgive the person who has caused us pain. Born out of a mold, you're here to stay, glazed with the torturous oven fire, till a stranger picks and takes you away and pretends to be your lost sire. Oh, porcelain doll, fragile as can be careful of this cold, brutal world. The hand holding you may last not long, your innocent eyes simply fail to see. This poem is actually dedicated to all the downtrodden women of our country who've been socially suppressed. They're nothing but ornaments in the whole house. They are like porcelain dolls who are lifeless and who are just kept in a beautiful showcase as an ornament. There are 6 steps to the Poetic Devil's Workshop. The step 1 is activating the devil inside us. The second step is when we sketch a picture in our mind and we paint whatever we are feeling. The third step is when the devil inside us becomes a part of the picture. The fourth step is word conversion, wherein we process this picture into words. The fifth step is sentence formation, wherein we use these words in order to form sentences. And the last step is choosing the form of poetry that I want to write for the sun. I can write anywhere, everywhere, and in the middle of nowhere. I don't need a particular scenario wherein I need to pen down my thoughts. It can be very, very random, very abrupt, waking up in the middle of the night or working in the office. Any particular scenario fascinates me, which gives me that urge to feel my emotions. This book, because it's in the form of a workshop, can work like a guideline for a person who wants to experiment with different poetry forms and attempt using them in his writing. It is a synthesis of merging the old classic poetry forms into modern poetry. This workshop is a tribute to all the brilliant poets of the past and the legacy that they have left for our generation. It's a tribute to my favorite writer, Sylvia Plath. I shut my eyes and all the world drops dead. I lift my eyes and all is born again. I think I just made you up inside my head. Little devil, I think I made you up inside my head.